because of the president's comments about Disney and about Iger, what I wish the president would tweet about is the aftermath of an actual hurricane about Puerto Rico.
Yes.
Because we're at the start of a new hurricane season, and there's a lot of concern about Puerto Rico's readiness. Yeah. I do think we should address here, even though we have waited till the 27th minute of the hour, my fault, for not talking about this Harvard study. Why is it that Roseanne so overshadowed the Harvard study about the estimated Puerto Rican death toll? Why is it that Puerto Rico has been shortchanged by the press?
I think a couple of reasons. One, we are addicted to celebrities. I mean, in a sick way. We've been that way for a long time.
A celebrity culture.
Yeah, we're a celebrity culture, so that's one thing. What she said so went to the guts of the culture war in this country, and it was so ugly, even by the standards of social media rhetoric today. It was so shocking what she wrote. And then you, and here's the other part of it.
It's also relatively easy to cover. Everybody has an opinion. Everybody has an interest in it.
I agree, Brian, but there's also this deeper thing that people saw her show and saw the character of Roseanne Conner, who's likable in some ways. That show spoke to them in the same way that Trump did. And I'm not denigrating this. I think it was important. I'm from Wisconsin.
Very important.
For people to say in Wisconsin and Michigan and Pennsylvania, we hear you. We know how bad things are. She did that. So you like her in that artificially constructed Roseanne Conner character, and then the real Roseanne does something that's so repulsive and so ugly that it shocks you. This was a shocking moment in our culture.
And I need to jump in here because I grew up in Puerto Rico. My brother lives there. This is very personal to me. I talked about this morning. And I agree with you. This should not have been overshadowed. And I wonder if it's because it is Puerto Rico and it is not the mainland. I mean, I'm sorry, but Puerto Rico has essentially gotten the shaft from this administration. The way that the recovery has been treated, the preparation, what FEMA has done, was not nearly to the extent that they that it should have been done. And I wonder if these were 5,000 American citizens stateside, and if they weren't brown and if they didn't speak Spanish, I think we would be talking more about this.
Look, we don't know what the, I don't think we'll ever know what the real death toll was. This Harvard study found it could be 4,600, it could be higher, could be much lower. There's new data from the government that indicates there was a spike in the deaths after the hurricane. I was struck by two headlines on CNN.com that I think summarize this well. One said Americans viewed Hurricane Maria as if it was happening in another country.
Exactly.
To your point.
That's
and the second headline was also from CNN.com. It said, President Trump will have to deal with this. Puerto Rico will be an enduring stain on his legacy,
it
on his presidency.
It will be a very black mark on his
record. But maybe only if the press takes it seriously.
I agree. And I think it is our responsibility to try to continue to put, to shine the light on this. Let's think about this. The death toll, and you know, I've talked to a lot of people there anecdotally, to the administration down there and to medical folks that have worked in the field, and they say that it probably will be much higher than 5,000 because a lot of these deaths were not reported. People were having their loved ones who died in their houses. They were keeping them there after Maria because they didn't know what to do with them.
Right.
So I do think that this will go over 5,000, and that means that there will have been more American citizens killed in the aftermath of Maria than in 9/11 and Katrina combined. Let's think about that for a moment.
Let's take a quick break here, bring back the panel after a commercial break, to talk about another one of the biggest stories of the week, a media scandal that you probably heard about involving Joy Reid. More embarrassing blog posts from Joy Reid's past.